Thank you for joining me in the History of Science collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's look at a few treasures from the vault that throw light on the story of science and art in the Renaissance. As the printing revolution was transforming every field of science, Leonardo da Vinci published no books. Even though Leonardo's notebooks remained unprinted in manuscript form only, you may read them in this comprehensive 12-volume full-color facsimile series published by Trek. Despite a lack of publications, Leonardo's fame grew as word of his notebooks spread. The first work by Leonardo to be printed was this treatise on painting, published in 1651, a century after his death. This work conveys Leonardo's views on mathematical proportion in the human body, the physiology of vision, and plant physiology. And here is the second edition. Given Leonardo's understanding of art as an intellectual endeavor carried out in imitation of nature, it is impossible to separate his art theory from his understanding of science. Yet Leonardo did publish something during his lifetime with a little help from a friend. This work by Luca Pacioli, The Divine Proportion, published in 1519, contains the only material of Leonardo's printed during his own lifetime. Pacioli, a friend of Leonardo's, explains that Leonardo provided the geometrical figures reproduced in the book. Pacioli was a teacher of a teacher of Copernicus. This treatise applies geometry to principles of beauty and artistic composition, including typefaces and perspective drawing. This is the Institutes of Geometry by Albrecht Dürer. As another landmark work on perspective drawing, a generation or so before Galileo, this book is similar in its scope to the slightly earlier book by Pacioli. In this diagram, we see the making of a drawing of a lute with true perspective by means of a string drawn from the object through the canvas to the vanishing point on the wall. This beautiful work by Sirigotti, published in 1596 when Galileo was a young man, brings the tradition of perspective drawing represented by Pacioli, Leonardo, and Dürer up to Galileo's time. Galileo studied this treatise by Sirigotti, and the principles of perspective drawing shaped his approach to science. The work contains 64 full-page copperplate engravings, applying the principles of perspective to architecture and drawing. The geometrical diagrams in Sirigotti's work are shaded beautifully. A celebrated example of chiaroscuro, the Renaissance technique of depicting light and shadow. Historians are persuaded that Galileo's training in the visual arts played a critical foundation in his astronomical discoveries and in the development of the new physics. Science is a story. What stories do you want to hear and tell about science and Renaissance art?